Derek, where did you get the concept for this exhibition? Where did it come about?
The concept for Tallaght came about when I was going down memory lane. Having gone to school in Tallaght, been raised in Walkerstown, just wanted to see what was on the net. And the first thing I saw was about Domino's Pizza's record sales in 2006, which obviously is a fantastic achievement for Domino's. But it tells me that here's a modern town now, Tallaght's totally changed. But you know, to try and find information about Tallaght's history is very difficult. And I think it's grossly underappreciated.
And did you find it hard trying to tap into the whole like spirit of what Tallaght was? Because I'll take that's what the exhibition is.
Well, I read a lot. There are lots of notes out there you can read. And you know, when I came to school in Tallaght, Tallaght was a little village. The priory, we used to call it the monastery, was like a special place to go to, because I mean, Walkerstown had that horrible big church, which it still has. You know, Tallaght, the priory, there was something magical about it. You were in the country, I mean, if you went to Bourne or Breda, that was literally going there for a day trip. I mean, the whole thing of distance and understanding, and I think Tallaght is grossly underappreciated, and I just felt I could do something with my art.
And you think that might be what's been lost in art lately? The whole, like, they're going almost away from the spiritual side of it and tapping into that, where they're just more doing what they see?
I can't talk for other artists. I know what I do. I meditate a lot on what I do. I examine myself. I will read a lot. What I won't actually... What I do is when I read a lot, I let the data, the information inform me. And when I do a canvas, I don't just go and do it. I don't do drawings. I work on the canvas straight. And then I build it up, and I'll leave a canvas. I might start and leave it for 2 months, work on another canvas, and come back to it. But I spend an awful lot of time looking, reviewing, and reading.
Have a preconception of what it will be like?
No, I just do it. It's very spontaneous. And but I think it's there in the back of your mind. I think I dream colours, I dream paintings. I think it's there because, without sounding egotistical, I mean, these works I think are brilliant. And, you know, I'm glad to be part of it. But I don't think it just happens. I think there's something in the creative cesspool of whatever, you know, whether it's God or whether it's whatever, it's cosmic, I don't know. I don't even try to know. There's something there.
Of course, you live in England now at the moment.
Yeah.
Do you find that actually the landscape of where you're living can affect what you'll actually paint? Or do you think that it's just whatever is there, it will always be there, no matter where you are?
I find that I'm painting better since I moved up to the north of England. I used to live down at Windsor. I find my painting has changed possibly because I'm happier up there. The people, they're very Irish. I mean, it's as near to Ireland as you can get in terms of personality. Okay, apart from the accents, you think you're in Dublin when you go to Liverpool. I think if you're a happier person and you have a better, you want to do something, you're happy to do it. So I think where you are is important.
Since you've been back over, have you got a chance to visit or see many things?
No, I haven't actually, not this time around. I do know some Irish artists, the likes of Eamon Coleman, Pauline Collins, Valerie Gleeson, Jean Conroy, these are brilliant artists. Ireland is what it is. I mean, Ireland's always been a bed of creativity. Even during this time, that was creativity, whether you liked religion or not.
Mm.
That was creativity.
And are you religious yourself or anything?
I don't know. I don't know. This place is amazing. I read in the paper, they said the local art centre. This is international. This isn't a little local art centre.
That's actually very little. Like, I didn't know about it until recently.
I tell you what, if I was running this place, I would have this place buzzing. This place is totally underutilised.
Art's also moved into, like, it's like a postmodern. You see a lot of it's incorporating technology now. Do you agree with that? Like, where they might use TV screens to show art and being broken up and then re-put together, like, they're incorporating that?
It's a big argument that conceptual art, installation work, how much of it's emperor's clothing, how much of it's genuine. I'm a physical artist, I like to paint, that's what I do. I know media because I've worked in computers most of my life, so I know what computers are about. I know quite a bit of my life, I know what technology is about. But I've never had the desire to do it in the modern media. I don't deny it. I mean, some of the modern work is beautiful. But as Eamon Coleman once wrote about me, I'm a mark maker. I make marks almost like a primitive. Maybe I'm a primitive, I don't know. I speak through my art. I don't speak through technology. Although you could say it is technology here, because I've used different mediums. I've used micro cemento and acrylics, so I've done something different here.
It's actually amazing how, like, we've actually been doing art in some form before we could even talk. Do you think it's actually more embedded in us? Like, the cavemen used to draw and use symbols.
Well, I know I'm built like a caveman. I could pass for a caveman, you know. I think it's an instinctive thing. I mean, my introduction to art was instinctive. I instinctively just fell into art. I actually used to go around all the skips up Ballymantle Lane and get all the bits out and make little collages and things like that. To me, it was just natural. It's like modern art to me is a natural language. I love portraiture, I love good art, but I never wanted to be a portrait painter. For me, it's like jazz. I mean, jazz, a lot of people don't even know what jazz is, but they like the sound. I just got into the movement of colour, the way colours make sound. Yeah.
And is there any other exhibitions coming soon, or will it take you a little while?
Well, I'm in Kilkenny, that's coming up shortly. Kilkenny Festival, Arts Festival.
What date is that?
Beginning of August, I don't have the exact date. I think it's the 5th to the 19th or something. I'm exhibiting with Elizabeth Cope.
And people can find out about that on the Kilkenny Arts Festival website.
They should go and see Elizabeth Cope's work. She's an amazing artist. Absolutely amazing.